Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome back to the magical world of Dark Souls. Today's episode is going to be random as hell. We've got a few loose ends to tie up. Then we're going to go head to the catacombs and take on Gravelord Nito. But first, this is what we're interested in. Remember over here where we saved Dusk of Ulysil? Now she's butt naked and we can get her gear. And this is what we want. The Crown of Dusk. When we have this equipped, we'll take twice as much damage from magic. That's a bad thing, but our magic and pyromancy will also do more damage. That's a good thing, so it's very handy for PvP. Okay. I'm going to go upgrade Maester's Flask to +4, then I'll see you back in Filing Shrine, where we will continue Sigmar's quest.
Well, hello again. I have finally located my father. All of your help was invaluable to us. Thank you so much. I was finally able to pass on my mother's last words. My father, he went on his final adventure. Don't worry, that's just the way he is. Undead or no, sort of reassuring really. If he goes hollow, I'll just have to kill him again.
Mind blown, yes you heard her correctly. She killed him. What a bitch. So that's why he's in the land of the undead. We will find out what happens with their storyline very soon, but next up, you remember I said next to the bed of chaos, there's a Tainar demon that respawned. We're gonna go kill him, hopefully not die to him, and then open up the shortcut that's past him. Then we will make a divine weapon and head down to the catacombs. Okay, so here he is. This is, as I mentioned, the only one in the entire goddamn game that actually respawns. So if you want to farm Demon Side Knight, this is the one you gotta kill. And as you can see, he's out on a giant walkway, where if we go either side, we die! And he can push us very, very easily. He's a complete dick, and I hate him. I hate him so goddamn much. He's killed me more times than I care to admit. Oh, shit! Okay, had that been a direct hit, I would have died, and that would have really sucked. Stealing my goddamn jump attacks, they're mine, you bastard. That's his grab attack. I've never actually been grabbed by that, so I don't really know what it does, but I imagine it probably gonna kill ya. It's very, very easy to avoid, though. Yeah, the jump attack is the one you gotta watch out for. That and him, you know, pushing you off the side. Good lord, does it suck. Come at me, bro. Just don't jump. Jump attacks are my job. Fireball of justice. That was not a fireball of justice. That was a fireball of goddamn missing. There we go. We're doing good damage with our fire. That might be the only saving grace we have here, because our regular Club of Doom is not going to be that effective against this guy, because Tainar demons have ridiculous physical defense. Holy crap, that nearly hit me. Die. Just freaking die. Get away from me. No. Nice try, scumbag. Right, we got to strafe around him. Okay. Burn, you son of a bitch. Burn. Oh, crap. Wow, that was close. Ran out of great combustion, almost got myself killed, and I don't know why I just drank that Estus, frankly. I panicked. That's not gonna hit. God damn, man. God damn. Please hit him. Okay, the time that demon is down, that was scary. That guy is insanely dangerous, and I've died to him more times than I care to admit. Okay, so now he's dead, we can go past him and open up the shortcuts. And in the process, we can get something called the Sunlight Maggot. You can wear it on your head, it looks absolutely ridiculous. And it will produce light. We are going to need light for the catacombs because the catacombs are pitch bloody black. There's only two other ways to get light in the game. One of them's the lantern, but that wastes your shield slot and you don't get it until you're in the catacombs. Jump check. And the other one is the light spell, but we don't have the intelligence to equip that because our guy is thick as crap. Okay, we got some combat coming up, so I'm going to put on my armor. Plus, you know, it makes us look like a complete badass. And that's always a good thing. Yeah, this fight's, I'm not gonna spoil what it is before we actually get there, but it's very, very sad indeed. You'll see, honey. You'll see.
Finally, I have. My very own son. I am the son. I've done it. I have. Yes. I did. Oh. It's over. My son. It's setting. It's dark. So dark.
So yes, our poor friend Solaire has put on the Sunlight Maggot and lost his freaking mind. He's gone absolutely insane. I want to point out the fact that he has not turned hollow. Hollows don't speak in this game. They never, never speak. He's simply lost his mind. Not gone hollow. We don't really know why. Maybe the Sunlight Maggot on your head does something to your brain. It's never really explained, but yeah. We had to kill the poor bastard. We put him out of his misery. He was looking for his son. He thought he'd found it. Turns out not so much. But hey, we got his armor. Score! So anyway, now we can open up the shortcut. This will, as I mentioned, take us back to just in front of the Demon Fire Sage. Literally, as you're going into the boss room, this is to the right of it. Okay. We are going to want a divine weapon for the catacombs. You don't need it, but it makes it a lot more easy. That was good English, a lot more easy. Anyway, we have an occult club. If you downgrade an occult club, it'll become a divine club, and it has the same stat requirements as our club of doom, so we can use that. So I'm going to go downgrade it at Peter Andre of Astora, then I'll see you in Final Shrine. We will finally head to the catacombs. Okay, here we are back in Final Shrine. I have my divine club in hand. Now, the reason we need this is because in the catacombs, there are skeletons. Very similar to the ones in the graveyard, but not the same. The ones in the catacombs are all controlled by necromancers. Necromancy. If you kill the necromancer, the skeletons stay dead. The ones that, you know, that particular necromancer commands. But if you don't, when you kill the skeletons, they will reform unless you kill them with a divine weapon. So it makes it a hell of a lot easier. And there are skeletons exactly like that in the Nito boss fight. So yeah, that boss fight is so much easier if you have a divine weapon. It's ridiculous. So even though we're not going to hit this hard, this is going to make our lives a lot easier because we can actually keep these things from reforming and getting back up and, you know, gangbanging us in a corner, because that will happen. It's happened to me many, many times. And it sucks. Tactical roll. Jump attack. Did I get him? Yes, I did. That was pretty goddamn freaking awesome, you must admit. God, I love my tactical rolls. I love the fact that this armor hurts people when you run into them. That's just way too awesome. Oh, God. Ambushed. Get the hell out of here, you son of a bitch. Yeah, if your bleed bar fills up, you'll lose half your HP, so don't do that. It sucks. There is a lot of hidden treasure down here. There's a very good weapon. It's probably the best dex weapon in the entire game, called the Great Scythe. And you kind of have to do some semi-platforming, shall we say, to get to that thing. We'll see. I mean, I'll try and get it just to show you guys, but I'm terrible at platforming, so I might die a million times trying to get to the damn thing. There's also the Dark Moon Sales Ring that allows you to get into the Dark Moon Covenant. That's probably the second biggest PvP covenant besides the Dark Wraiths. How the hell did I hit you with that? I don't know, but I'll take it. I'll take it. Okay, so this wall here, we can lower this by pulling a switch that's down below, and there happens to be a bonfire down there as well, and I believe the first necromancer. Yes, indeed. Oh, God. Yeah, they shoot fire out of their lanterns, and they can drop their lanterns, but very rarely. You do get a guaranteed one, but it's quite a ways in, so yeah. Push that switch, baby. Yes, work those arm muscles. Okay, I am warning you now, if you thought I was bad at New London and died to the ghosts a lot, you ain't seen nothing yet. I am ridiculously bad at the catacombs, just shockingly bad. Shockingly bad, and the Tomb of the Giants as well, and the Tomb of the Giants connects right onto the end of it, so that's where Nito is. So yeah, you're probably going to watch me die many, many times. Some of you will take enjoyment out of that if you like watching other people suffer. Some of you will get extremely frustrated. You are warned. Don't say I didn't warn you. Okay, so out here we have a shitload of skeletons, like I do mean a lot, and they are guarding a necromancer around the corner. Necromancy, and he's across the bridge, so we could fall off there and die as well, and you know how good I am at platforming. That is to say, I'm absolutely terrible, I'm probably the worst person you've ever seen at platforming in your entire life. So, okay, we made it across the bridge, believe it or not, that shocks me. Right, we gotta try and backstab this son of a bitch before we get mocked by his bloody skeletons. God diggity damn it. Oh my God, don't roll up my ass. Come here, you son of a bitch. Backstab him, come on, yes! Okay, that should kill him, I think? I think he's dead. Okay, he's dead, good. Whew, just about healed in time. Oh my God, this is not good. We're gonna bleed, we gotta be careful. Jump attack! Oh God, I missed everyone, no! Didn't I tell you I was terrible at this? I warned you, at least we killed the necromancer. That's something. Okay, I believe we're pretty much here. Yes, there we go, there's my blood sink, give it to me. Okay, this time, kill them one at a time. Don't get surrounded like a fucking idiot. This, I believe, is Lucerne. This is a very good weapon. Has a very nice moveset. And all of its attacks are thrust attacks. The Leo Ring boosts thrust attack damage. So, if you use the Leo Ring and Lucerne together, every single hit, you will get the boosted damage from the Leo Ring. It's very nice. It's very nice indeed. Plus, like I said, it's just a good weapon in general. Get the hell out of here, you scumbag. There is a Great Scythe around here, which is probably the best dex weapon in the game. And being a scythe, it has absolutely ridiculous reach, so it's very good. I'm trying to remember exactly where it is. I know we have to drop down and go, oh God, I know we have to drop down a couple of ledges to get to it, but can't remember where the hell it is. These statues, by the way, if you walk too close to them, sometimes spikes will come out and hit you. It does almost no damage, but it will stagger you. And you'll probably get beaten up by the skeleton, so if you can avoid it, don't go near those damn things. It's a death trap. I see you, Mr. Skeleton, trying to sneak an arrow in. There's one more behind those pots over there, but every damn time he gets stuck behind them. Jump attack, so we'll put him out of his misery. I believe this is a soul consumable. I think we are close to the Great Scythe, but we're going to want to open up an illusory wall to get to another bonfire first. And I believe we may meet an NPC here, although sometimes he doesn't show up, and I really have no idea why. There's probably some kind of rhyme or reason to it, but I don't know. We're going to want to rotate that bridge so we can go across it, because as you can see, it's covered in spikes. Get the hell away from me, exploding skull. I think there's some more skeletons around here. There's definitely more skulls. I see another one over in the distance, and I'm worried about these goddamn statues because they're going to try and stab me on the way past. Blow up, damn you. There we go. Oh, God. See, that's what I'm talking about. That almost got me hit by that skull. And those things hit deceptively hard, like really fucking hard. Plus, they can just blast you off the side from the force, even if you block it. So, yeah, not good, man. Jump attack. Not good. I almost went right off the side. God damn. Had a couple of close calls, though, didn't we? What's up, buddy? Don't you block me. Oh, crap. I forgot that's actually his parry stance. So, yeah, if you hit when he's doing that, he's going to parry you. Luckily. Oh, God. He doesn't do as much damage as I do with my parries. Otherwise, I would have died. Perfect opportunity to heal. Good work, buddy. Jump attack. By the way, I don't know if I mentioned this, but enemies cannot parry the jump attack on the club. Very, very handy. Okay, so now we've pushed that switch lever thing, whatever the hell it is. That should have rotated the bridge. Hopefully exactly where we want it. Meet a soul of a proud knight. Nice. So, I believe, unless I'm very much mistaken, this is the bridge where we can jump off to get down to the Great Scythe. But you know when I'm like a platforming, so I'm probably gonna die a million times trying to get to the damn thing. Ow! Dick statue. Yeah, it's down on the left, but first we have to get rid of the necromancer and his buddies. Come at me, bro. Holy shit. Oh my god. Wow. If you didn't see that, please rewind the video. That skeleton just freaking Supermaned off the side. That was awesome. 10 out of 10. Woo! That was good times, man. That was good times. How the hell is this guy not dead? What the hell? I think you're the real Man of Steel. Give me a lantern. Oh, you freeloader. Right, before we grab the scythe, if we drop down here, this will take us to a couple of hidden crystal lizards, and it will lure us back around to where we were just outside. I think, I hope I'm right, but as you can see, there are statues in the way, and they're probably going to make us get stunned and not get to them in time. Yeah. Nice try, buddy. Nice try. Gotcha. The other one got away, but you can just come back and they'll be there again. I think you have to turn the game off and back on. There's something you have to do. Some kind of load screen or something. I don't remember exactly how it works. Okay, let's go back and go get our goddamn Great Scythe, and I'm going to be real pissed off if I fall to my death. Alright, you know, plan B. Instead of getting the Great Scythe now, we're going to go find the next bonfire, because frankly, I'm worried I'm going to fall and die. It's probably going to happen, and you know I'm right. So, we're going to find the next bonfire, then I'll come back and get it. So that way, when I die, inevitably, because I will, I at least won't have to run so freaking far, because that will really, really suck. Okay, we have another blacksmith coming up pretty damn soon. This one is the one that makes fire and chaos weapons, so all those flame embers and everything we got earlier, this is the guy we have to give them to, so he's very, very handy. Oh, by the way, I forgot to mention, every blacksmith in the game has a unique hammer, that if you kill them, you'll get it as a drop, but it's probably not a good idea. I recommend you do that before you go to New Game Plus, because all the blacksmiths are damn useful. I think the giant in Anolondo has the most powerful one, but this guy we're about to see also drops a helm when you kill him, and it's got horns on it. It looks a bit like the Skyrim Nordic helm, but you know, not quite the same. But yeah, if you're going to kill any of them, this is probably the one to do, because fire and chaos weapons are useful, but nowhere near as much as lightning, in my opinion, because there's a lot of stuff in this game that's weak to lightning. Like a hell of a lot. And if they're weak to fire, you can just use pyromancy, so it's not really a huge deal. At least in my opinion. Oh, crap! I did not see you over there. Well, it's time to freaking retreat. I think one of them fell down. That's very handy, but we're very nearly dead. I think he fell down too. Oh, thank God. That scared the crap out of me. I really did not see him. Right, come here, you son of a bitch. I'm gonna reap my revenge. Oh, you know you can shoot me. That works too. Die, you scumbag. Jump attack. How the hell are you still alive? Why do you have so much damn HP? Thank you. Hey, and he dropped us our lantern. What a nice guy. If you have a spare one, you can trade it to Snuggly the Crow and get the Ring of Fog. When you have the ring equipped, you'll be almost invisible. It's pretty damn cool, if you ask me. Now, if we go up, we can go through the door we just opened with the lever to get to the bonfire, but screw that nonsense. We're gonna go this way first. We can always double back. It ain't no problem. It ain't no problem. Down here will take us to the blacksmith. I think there's still a skeleton alive down here, isn't there? Yes. You ready? Plunging attack. That's what you get, buddy. That's what you get. Damn, we're out of Estus. Well, that sucks. Oh crap! I forgot about the other skeleton! Holy crap! Okay, so this is the blacksmith. First time I saw this guy, I thought he was gonna beat the living shit out of me with that pickaxe. Kinda scared me.
My, is that an ember from New Nondo? And a fine ember it be. What do you say? Why not leave it with me? I'll give you a flame to feast your eyes upon. Yes, yes, very well. We'll get these old bones to work.
Oh, shut up, you miserable bastard. So this guy, as I said, can make fire and chaos weapons. He sells homeward bones, because you know he's a skeleton, and it makes sense to me. He sells titanite shards and arrows, and that is literally it. So if you have no interest in fire or chaos weapons, you may as well kill him to get the badass helmets and his hammer of doom and destruction.
Well, what was that about? Don't be coming around here without a good reason. Why, you have an ember, do you? Ah, forget about it. I don't deal with that kind. What has gone wrong with embers these days? Well, what was that?
Okay, so up next we have an enemy that I see in my nightmares. I'm not kidding, these things have killed me so many goddamn times. Where the hell are they? Yes, there they are. The bone wheel skeletons. Bone saw is ready. Oh, Jesus Christ, this is not good. This is not good. How the hell did that not kill me? Kill them quickly. Why do I have this weapon on? I should have the lightning club of doom on. Holy shit, how am I still alive? Yeah, if you actually get hit by them, they will tear you to pieces extremely quickly with that roll attack. And we have no Estus, and there's quite a lot of them out here. So yeah, I fully expect I'm gonna die. You have been warned. You have been warned. Okay, so we have two directions here. This way I'm heading now. That will take us to where Nito is in the Tomb of the Giants. That's the way we're supposed to go. The other direction is where we would have come from had we not dropped down... Oh, God! Had we not dropped down the secret passageway to get to the blacksmith. But at least the wall's open now because he smashed through it, so we have a shortcut to get back here should I die, which I fully expect I'm going to. There's only a couple more. We might be okay. Right, die, you son of a bitch. Oh, shit. Oh, damn. I told you it was going to happen. Right, well, at least we can go get the Great Scythe now. Okay, so this is where you get the scythe. Now, I'm pretty damn certain you are not supposed to jump down onto this bridge on the left here. But I see a fog wall over there, so I really want to try it. This is probably going to get me killed. Okay, yes, you cannot land on that bridge. Okay, so this time, instead of rolling off onto that bridge and dying like a complete wanker, I think I have a better idea. If we go out here, down on the right, we can roll down to these ledges. We've still got to be careful. Oh my god. That was some scary shit. And this should take us to the Great Scythe. There you go. See the things I do for you people. I can't even wield the damn thing. Alright, so I have no idea where I am. So I'm going to bone back to the bonfire. We'll go find the next one behind the illusory wall and end the video there. Okay, so straight ahead of us. Down on the right, that's where we got the Great Scythe. If we go out here and on the left, there will be a hidden illusory wall right ahead of us that will contain the next bonfire we need. I seriously cannot believe I tried to land on that goddamn bridge. What an idiot. Alright guys, I'm gonna end the video here. Next time, we finish the catacombs, take on the Tomb of the Giants, and pound Gravelord Nito into dust. And then all we have to do is beat the DLC and the final boss. Thanks for watching guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, I always appreciate it when you click on the like button. And I'll see you guys next time for more Dark Souls.